Hi, I'm Nikki Jabor. And while large flowering bulbs like tulips and daffodils typically steal the spotlight in spring, there are many small flowering bulbs, often called minor bulbs, that can be just as dazzling. Today, I'm going to share my favorite small flowering bulbs, as well as offer tips on planting these early bloomers. When I'm shopping for bulbs, I find myself gravitating towards the minor bulbs like crocus, Siberian squill, glory of the snow, and dwarf iris. Many bloom very early in spring, and often through drifts of snow. They're among the first plants to bring color to the garden. These bulbs also provide an important source of pollen and nectar for the first pollinators of the season, typically native bumblebees. Before you head to the garden center, take a look around your property to see which spots would benefit from small blooming bulbs. There are some bulbs that thrive in sunny spaces, and others that prefer the partial shade beneath tall trees or shrubs. Some are also perfect for naturalizing in meadows, lawns, and large gardens. Now, when buying bulbs, read the plant descriptions carefully so you select those that will do well in the growing conditions of your garden. Once you've got your small flowering bulbs, it's time to plant. Large bulbs like tulips and daffodils are planted about 6 inches deep, but smaller bulbs should only be planted 3 to 4 inches deep. A good rule of thumb is to plant bulbs 3 times their diameter. Space the small bulbs 3 inches apart, planting them in large drifts of at least a dozen plants for maximum flower power. There's no shortage of small flowering bulbs that will thrive in your spring garden. Here are 5 of my favorites. In my garden, the crocus bulbs begin to bloom through the snow, usually in late March. Their cheerful purple, yellow, or white blossoms add welcome color to the early spring garden, and the plants can naturalize in garden beds or even when planted in the lawn. There are 2 types of spring flowering crocus, the species and the hybrids. Species crocus typically flower earlier than hybrid crocus and also have unique colors and patterns on the blooms. Hybrids have big flowers and often flower for a longer period of time. Dwarf iris, or iris reticulata, is one of the earliest spring flowering bulbs to bloom, typically through the snow. Unlike Siberian or bearded irises, this species is very compact. The flowers grow just 4 to 6 inches tall. There are different varieties with varied flower colors and petal markings. This bulb grows best in full sun with well-draining soil. And when planted in the right site, the bulbs tend to naturalize and form large clumps of the pretty petite flowers. Glory of the Snow is one of my favorite early flowering bulbs and earned its name from its early blooming time. This hardy small flowering bulb grows best in full sun to dappled shade, and I have large clumps tucked beneath the deciduous trees on my property. The star-shaped flowers are typically sky blue and white, but there are also pink and white flowering varieties as well. The small blooms are produced in sprays of 5 to 10 flowers and persist for 2 to 3 weeks. Snowdrops are a classic late winter and early spring bulb that emerge in the garden from late March through early April. The dainty bell-shaped flowers are pure white with attractive green markings. They grow 6 to 10 inches tall and thrive in a partially shaded site, such as beneath tall trees. Siberian squill is a hardy, low-growing plant that's perfect for naturalizing in rock gardens or beneath deciduous trees. Each bulb produces 3 to 4 scapes, and each scape has 1 to 3 bell-shaped purple-blue flowers. The entire plant grows just 4 to 6 inches tall, and when planted in groups of at least 6, adds eye-catching color to the early garden. Other small bulbs you may wish to plant include Aranthus, Allium molly, Grape hyacinths, and Snake's Head fritillary. Happy growing!